Hello everyone, HPI Guys Model Workshop, showing you another styrene kit that I picked up. This is the Lindbergh Southern Bell 1/64th scale of a paddle wheel ship. This was a paddle wheel ship back in the mid-1800s. It would have been down south where they used a huge amount of paddle wheelers on the Mississippi River to move cargo, cotton bales up and down rivers. You know, they had a flat bottom so they could get into real shallow drives. As we've talked about in other reviews, I absolutely love boats. I love especially older boats, whether they're plastic models, whether they are wood models, which are my forte. I absolutely love plank on hull wood models, and I've built a good amount of those. Most of those I do resell to other people. I've kept a few of them. I have a few in my office, have a few there. And I love paddle wheelers. I think they are just a, to not be corny, but a romantic style of boat. They operate quietly. They operate just, they're very lazy looking. They're very fun looking. They're like a little house with a motor on the back of it. They use steam power, so it's not a big engine running in there that makes a lot of noise. So when I saw this kit available, now that round two is purchased Lindbergh and they started reproducing a lot of Lindbergh kits, I had to grab it. I got this for $26.99 shipped from Tower Hobbies. Let's take a look at what's in the box. First thing up is going to be the main hull pieces. And I'll show you those here. This is all in one bag. And you can see here that they've got a lot of the stuff all stuffed into one bag. And we'll push everything up so you can get a good look at it. And this is your main hull, so that's going to be the size of your boat, and it's not small at all. It's going to be a good size. I hate when you open up a box and it's, you know, a 4-inch kit and the box is 2 feet long. So you can see on the board here the entire hull. We'll line it up with the squares there. Will be 10 inches long. And then, of course, you've got to add the paddle wheel off the back of it. So you're going to be looking at about a 13-inch kit on average when you get all done with it, which is a great size. It's still small enough to display, but it's big enough to put a lot of detail in it, which I love doing. Lindbergh has engraved some great details on there. You can see all the planking on the hull, which is going to take a wash really well. And you're going to be able to even get the camera to focus in on that. There you go. You can see all the planking on the hull. So you'll be able to wash that real nice with a darker wood wash. And they even include a stand for you. And I just push that together real quick. But you can either glue the boat right to the top of the stand, or you can let it sit free. So that'll be really nice for display. It would just sit all by itself right on the flat base. But it's cool that they give you a display with the name on it. You can see the upper and lower decks are all engraved well. Let's see, that'll show up on there. So you're going to be, you know, breaking out the stains and washes and the wood-colored paint and the leather-colored paint to get this to look like a real wood ship. And then you can whitewash it as well, like they did on the box and in real life, to make it look like weathered wood. And you can either have this be a brand new paddle wheeler just ready to start working, or you can weather the heck out of it and have it be a well-worn riverboat. You can see some more of the decks on there. Beautiful engraving, almost no flash whatsoever on any of the parts I saw. So I'm not sure how long Lindbergh has been putting this out, but I know it's been quite a while because I haven't heard of Lindbergh putting out anything new in over a decade. And some final parts, you've got the drive arms for the paddle wheeler, and you've got some really cool accessories for the deck. You've got different barrels, you've got rope cleats, mooring buoys. All that really fun stuff on there. They include it all in the box. Another shot here in a separate bag is more of another hull, and or of another deck, I'm sorry, and some paddle wheel parts. You can see the arches there for the mechanics. And more areas. This would be the upper deck for the railing. Very attractive, nice looking, well molded. Great deal for the price. The last two parts trees are very, very flexible, so I kind of got to lay them down. But you can see on there the delicate parts for the paddle wheel, the steam boiler, the individual rungs here for the railing right there. You can see the steam boiler's got beautiful rivet detail on it. So you're going to be able to bring that out. I'd paint that probably a light charcoal, then cover it with a dry brush of gray, a little silver, a little soot color. That's going to look the part perfectly. You can see the fine detail on the railings and on the paddle wheel arms itself. You can see the smokestacks. And this is just going to be a boat modeler's dream. This is a really nice kit. And it's a large size. They usually cost a lot more. But this size is very reasonably priced. You can see part of the railings there across the top. But you see that tree is really flexible, so that's why I'm being careful with it. The last tree that I have is even more floppy than the last one because of all the small details on it and the small runners. But you see the excellent details just don't stop. There's your paddles for the paddle wheeler. Here's your really cool figures. You can see those guys look awesome. They're going to be working on the ship. You've got a rescue boat and a rowboat. You've got your sides to the paddle wheel. You've got more cabin parts. And you've got some nice stairs. All well done. This is actually surprisingly good molding for Lindbergh. And I credit that, at least in my opinion, to the great job Round 2 Models has done since acquiring them and cleaning up the molds and putting out quality product again. And a lot of people scoff at Lindbergh stuff. There is some real clunkers out there that Lindbergh has made, especially in their car model line. But a lot of these, you know, different types of models that Lindbergh makes were the only option available, and they did a pretty good job on it. So moving on, that was the last of the plastic trees. They do include a very small decal set, but it is welcome because it does say Southern Belle, and painting that right there on the side would be difficult. You'd have to get some dry transfer letters because I certainly can't stencil out anything like that. So these are very welcome that they included that in the kit. I'm glad they did, that I didn't have to go source them from somewhere else. And then the final piece of the kit, of course, is the directions. And you can see here, everything is blown up. So it's very easy to understand. There is no writing. They just have very good 3D illustrations showing you how to assemble everything on the kit, how you're going to put it together, where everything should go, and painting and detailing. So you see how sweet that's going to look when you're done. Even if you're not a boat fan, paddle wheelers are just too cool to pass up, especially at this price and as readily available as they are going to be. Now that I've seen this kit, now that I've actually taken a look at it and saw the parts quality, I do know that Lindbergh does make at least one other paddle wheel boat, and I am definitely going to be ordering that. I can't wait to get it. I'm going to be building these for sure, because I love boat kits and paddle wheelers especially. I thank you for watching, and I hope to see you on the next review. Hey everyone, I just forgot something on this kit. It was hidden in the box under a spare set of directions they included, but I didn't want to leave it off because I like to be thorough. Lindbergh does include clear glass for most of the windows on the kit, and they all insert from the inside, and they look really nice. They're very clear, and they're going to resemble the style of glass they would have used back in the day. They're clear, but they're not perfectly clear, which would have been the style of glass back then. It wasn't crystal. So I just wanted to show you this. I didn't want to leave it off, but this is included in the kit, and I want to make sure you saw it. Thanks again.